So hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Aquafina. So in this video I am going to discuss about how to breed silver dollar fish in your home aquarium. So this fish can grow up to 6 inches in length and are delightfully flashy addition to any tropical freshwater tank. Breeding them in captivity is easy, yet male silver dollar fish are among the most difficult species to identify by sex. So the first step is how to distinguish between the male and female silver dollar fish. So like many fish, there are no distinctly obvious means of distinguishing between a male and a female silver dollar fish. The only way to tell the sex of a silver dollar fish is to study the anal fin. In male silver dollar fish, the anal fin may be slightly longer and may also be tinged red. Because it is difficult to sex silver dollar fish, the best way to prepare for breeding them is to purchase 6 or so juvenile fish and raise them together. This will allow the juvenile fish to grow together and to form bond with other fish and to establish breeding pairs. So another features of the female silver dollar fish that will tell you that it is ready for breeding is to when you see some two black spots just near the side of the gills. The red color on the side gills will turn black, so as it is time, it is the perfect time to place the male with the female in the same tank. So now let's talk about the silver dollar fish tank requirement. So silver dollar fish are typically peaceful fish in the home aquarium and they are generally easy to care for. Because this fish can grow up to 6 inches in length, they should be kept in a tank of at least 30 gallon in capacity, especially if you plan to keep them in a school. The ideal temperature range for a silver dollar fish is between 72 and 77 degree Fahrenheit with a pH between 5 to 7. So silver dollar fish should be offered a varied diet including flake food to provide basic nutrition supplemented with fresh vegetables and algae wafers. If you are keeping your silver dollar fish in a tank with other fish, you may need to watch out to make sure that more aggressive eater like tetra and barb do not keep your silver dollar fish from getting their share of the feed. Now let's talk about the breeding setup for your silver dollar fish. Once the fish have reached sexual maturity, set up a separate brooding tank and if you want a separate tank to raise the fry. The brooding tank should be dimly light and kept at a temperature around 80 degree Fahrenheit. Silver dollar fish are generally tolerant of different water qualities, but they do best in a slightly acidic tank with soft water pH which is 8 or less. This fish also prefer the lighting to be dim in the brooding tank. Unlike many egg layer, silver dollar fish don't make bubble nest, so it is best to fill the brooding tank with fine-leaved plant. This plant will provide protection for the fish and may also serve as a food source for the adult fish and the fry as they grow. So as mentioned earlier, silver dollar fish are egg layers and will need to provide spawning moth or clumps of Java moss to provide a surface for the egg to rest on. Breeding fish will use clumps of floating surface plant to spawn between, so be sure to provide that for them. As it has already been mentioned, silver dollar fish are an egg laying variety of fish. When the female lay eggs, she will lay up to 2000 at once and the male will then fertilize them. During breeding or spawning, the male will typically chase the female around for a while until she allows him to come beside her. Then the male silver dollar will then flip his body against her, releasing his sperm at the same moment that she begins to release her eggs. In some cases, the males may wrap his body around the females, fertilizing the eggs, and they are released. After that, you have to separate the males and the female in the separate tank. So after 3 days or so, the fry will be hatched and will begin to swim around the tank. Like any fry, newly hatched silver dollar fry need to be fed a diet of very fine foods like brine shrimp, crushed spirulina or specially formulated fry foods. So if you feed the fry regularly during the first few days of life, they will grow quickly and will have a greater chance of developing into a healthy adult. Fry that are not fed adequately during the first few days after hatching often experience stunted growth and they may never achieve full size at maturity. Though breeding silver dollar fish can be a tricky at times, it is well worth the effort. Not only are these fish uniquely beautiful, but they make great addition to the community tank. Be aware, however, that these fish are eaters of live plant, so if you plan to keep them in your aquarium, be sure to stick to either plastic plants or other varieties of live plant. So these are all information regarding the breeding process of your silver dollar fish. I hope this video will help you. More videos are coming soon, so please stay tuned to my channel.